Well, as Mike said, this is a brand new chapter, and I really have to commend Mike and Dr. Susan Maher for their work on a total revamp, or a major revamp, not total, but a major revamp of the general training for the State of Wisconsin Master Gardener Program. And it was done in a very short period of time, but they really had the vision to see what needed to be changed and to make those changes. We all worked together from kind of a retreat that we did together, and one of the things we decided is that we needed to have a chapter on general gardening practices, because there are so many kind of general principles of gardening, so many practices that you use, kind of no matter what type of plant it is, and so we need to describe those proper methods of planting, proper methods of watering, proper methods of fertilizing, the basics of the practices you use to cultivate plants, and then from plant to plant and crop to crop, you can get a little more specific, and that's what the other chapters are doing. So that's what this chapter is all about. It is a brand new chapter, and we are following along with the chapter for tonight's presentation. So we won't go over everything that's in the chapter, but we're covering kind of the highlights and giving you some visual images to put along with those concepts that we'll be talking about. So starting off with site selection. The very first thing is deciding what to plant where, and to do that you need to take into consideration the function that the plant is going to perform in the landscape. And landscape design is a great way to really give some thought to that. That's one of the things that landscape design really addresses, and there is a chapter on landscape design, so that's a good place to give a little more thought to that. Is that plant serving the purpose of creating a barrier between you and an unsightly view? Is that plant a specimen plant? Is it part of a group planting that's to draw your eye to a certain part of the property? So plant function is one criteria, and then looking at the conditions of the site. And when you do that, it's extremely important to be as accurate and as detailed with that information as possible. I think sometimes we get used to our properties and think of one area as shady and one area as sunny, and maybe we really only see that area at certain times of the day most of the time. And so we think of it as being this bright, sunny area, but it's really only sunny from about 11 o'clock in the afternoon or in the morning until about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And then it's a lot shadier for the rest of the time. Or maybe it used to be a very sunny area, and now we have a lot of trees that have grown up around it, and it really isn't all that sunny anymore. So to be really quite frank and quite detailed in our analysis of the site, the light conditions, the soil on the site, and existing features that you're working with, whether it be the hose bibs or the air conditioner or a structure, those are the things to take into consideration when looking at the site that you're going to be planting a new plant in.